Amebiasis is a disease caused by a microscopic protozoan called Entamoeba histolytica. It's estimated that 10% of the world population is infected by this microbe, resulting in approximately 50 million cases of invasive amebiasis and up to 100,000 deaths per year. This parasite can infect people of any age, but it's more common in children and young adults. To watch the Spanish version of this video, go to the description box where you'll find a link. The prevalence of amebiasis varies greatly between the different regions of the planet, from only 1 to 2% in temperate climate zones, up to 50% in many tropical countries whose regions are hot and humid. There are different species of amoebas that can parasite the human mouth and intestinal tract. For example, E. histolytica, E. harmanni, E. coli, Endolimax nana, and lodamoeba butschlii. However, only some strains of Entamoeba histolytica cause disease. The others, when they exist, establish a relationship of commensalism with the human body, where they don't cause disease, so that in such cases, no treatment is required. The most frequent mechanisms of transmission of amebiasis are the consumption of contaminated water or food, indirect anus hand mouth contact. Due to its clinical manifestations, amebiasis is classified as asymptomatic and symptomatic by its location in intestinal and extraintestinal and by its evolution in acute and chronic. Let's discuss intestinal amebiasis. Asymptomatic intestinal infection is the most common form of amebiasis. However, 1 in 10 people infected with Entamoeba histolytica does develop symptoms. In these symptomatic patients, the typical form of the disease is dysenteric amebiasis. The initial symptoms of these disorders are generally mild, with lack of appetite, abdominal pain, and mild non-bloody diarrhea. The symptoms reflect the existence of an irritative process in the large intestine or colon, and it's an initial phase of the disease, which can last for several months. But once the large intestine is extensively invaded, the symptoms become more intense and the disease enters a stayed period. In this phase, the most outstanding symptoms are diarrhea. It's the most frequent characteristic. In most cases, it's very nonspecific, with soft or watery stools and a bad smell, and sometimes with mucus, pus, and the presence of blood in stretch marks. Diarrhea usually lasts for several weeks and can alternate with phases of constipation. Abdominal pain. The intensity of this is very variable and ranges from a feeling of heaviness in the abdomen to colic-type pain, which decreases with defecation. Another symptom is tenesmus, which occurs in the most severe cases and consists of the sensation that it's necessary to defecate, even when the intestines are already empty. This sensation is usually accompanied by pain, cramps, and straining to have bowel movement. Now let's talk about extraintestinal amebiasis. Entamoeba histolytica is usually found as a commensal organism in the large intestine, but it occasionally penetrates the intestinal mucosa and can invade other organs. The most common type of extraintestinal amebiasis is liver abscess. This disease begins with a slow and insidious course, accompanied by weight loss, pain in the liver area located on the upper right side of the abdomen, not very high fever, usually 101 to 103 degrees Fahrenheit, mild enlargement of the liver, which in medical terms is known as hepatomegaly, in addition to discrete jaundice, which manifests as the presence of a yellowish color in the sclera, which is the white part of the eyes. Entamoeba histolytica is found in the human intestine in two forms, the trophozoid or motile form, which is the invasive form, and the cyst, which is the infective form. The diagnosis of intestinal amebiasis is suspected based on the patient's signs and symptoms, and is confirmed by the demonstration of Entamoeba histolytica in the feces. Through a study called coprotozoanparasitoscopic for the search of cysts and fresh amoeba for trophozoids. However, the detection of extraintestinal amebiasis is more difficult. In these cases, stool studies are usually negative, and trophozoids can rarely be demonstrated in purulent material. The tests available with the highest degree of sensitivity are indirect hemagglutination and enzyme-linked immunoabsorbent assay, or ELISA, and imaging techniques in cases of liver abscess. Intestinal amoebiasis can be treated with natural home remedies or medication. The former include garlic, turmeric, and oregano. Garlic contains active sulfur ingredients that have an antibiotic and antiparasitic effect on the intestine and also help regulate the intestinal flora. It can be taken in different ways. For example, you can chew and eat one clove of raw garlic daily after lunch. Allicin is the substance responsible for the smell of garlic, so people who are intolerant to this are advised to mince the garlic and let it sit for 15 minutes before using it as remedy. In this short period, the smell of garlic decreases significantly without losing its medicinal properties. It can also be prepared as an infusion, in which case 3 cloves of garlic should be chopped, placed in a container with 250 ml of water, and heated. When it's already at its boiling point, remove from the heat, let stand for about 20 minutes, and strain. It's recommended to take the mixture daily once a day. Finally, another way to prepare it is to crush 3 cloves of garlic and boil them in 250 ml of milk. After having strained the preparation, it can be sweetened to taste with sugar or honey. It should be taken warm at night. Now let's move on to turmeric. It has an active ingredient called curcumin, which, in addition to inhibiting the growth of worms and protozoa, it's rich in antioxidants and has anti-inflammatory properties. For its preparation in tea, it's required 1 tablespoon of turmeric powder, equivalent to about 5 grams, and 1 cup of water. After boiling the water, add the turmeric and then let it rest for 5 to 10 minutes. Drink 2 to 3 cups per day between meals. Finally, oregano helps eliminate gases accumulated in the digestive tract, has anti-inflammatory action, and is very useful in the treatment of intestinal amoebiasis. For its preparation in tea, it's required 1 tablespoon of dried oregano in 250 ml of water. Bring the water to a boil, add the oregano, let it boil for 3 minutes, let it rest, strain, and that's it. Drink 1 cup in the morning and 1 at night. If desired, it can be sweetened with honey to taste. Whichever remedy is chosen, it's recommended to take it for 2 weeks. Regarding the pharmacological treatment of asymptomatic or chronic intestinal amoebiasis, one of the following oral medications can be used: dialoxinate furate, diiodhydroxyquinoline, or paromomycin. In acute symptomatic intestinal amoebiasis, the drug of choice is metronidazole and the second option is tinidazole. A combination of metronidazole and diiodhydroxyquinoline can also be used, which, being an irritating mixture, is recommended to be taken after meals. We conclude by saying that amoebic liver abscess is a complicated disease that can be treated with metronidazole, followed by a 10-day course of diiloxinate furate or paromomycin. However, in all cases, it will always be the treating physician who determines the most specific medication and the respective dose, based on the severity of the disease and the particular characteristics of the patient, such as age, weight, concomitant diseases, etc. Well, that's all for now. See you in the next video.